Jim looked away from his computer. He had just about finished his work for the day. He almost forgot about the final report that was extremely important to his boss. If he didn't finish it tonight, he would be fired. Or at least that is what his employer let on. He was told not to come into the office today, and to finish his work in the comfort of his own home. To concentrate better, his boss told him. Jim had been on his computer since about 1 in the afternoon, and it was now 8 p.m. He only took breaks to eat and to check on his newborn son, whom was only about a month old. His wife and he had been married for about 3 years before they decided to try and have a child. They were joyful as their first baby was healthy and, they hoped, happy. Jim stretched in his chair and looked at his computer screen once again. He quickly saved his report, and then he wondered when his wife would return from grocery shopping. Jim sat back in his chair and looked at the ceiling. He closed his eyes and began to doze off. And before long, he was awoken by the sound of crying. Soft, faint crying. He looked around, wondering where the sound was coming from, and then he noticed the baby monitor on his desk. Well, Jim thought, time to check on little Steven again. Just as he started to stand up, he heard the sound of a door opening in the baby monitor. Jim stopped and listened. He then heard the sound of his wife singing a lullaby. Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Mama's gonna buy you a mockingbird. And if that mockingbird won't sing, Mama's gonna buy you a diamond ring. Jim sat back down. He laid back in his chair again and started to doze off once more. The sound of his wife singing the lullaby wasn't just making the baby sleepy, but him too. This is a start to a wonderful family, Jim thought to himself. Just as he closed his eyes, he heard the front door creak open. Jim watched as his wife walked in with grocery bags in both hands. He looked back at the baby monitor, his wife's voice still singing the lullaby. He then stared back at his wife for a brief moment before he sprinted to the stairs and raced to his newborn's room. His wife dropped the groceries and ran after her husband. As Jim was running, he kept thinking, "No, no, no, what is happening here?" Jim bolted to the door and almost destroyed it as he threw it open. Jim gazed into the room and then he witnessed something he will never forget. No matter how hard he tried to.